In this video, I will create only one text animation using simple minimal tools in DaVinci Resolve, and then I will transform that text animation into four unique design that is awesome for video editing project. So without any further ado, let's go. Alright guys, so let's start by creating a new fusion composition here. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. This is going to be the text 1. Duration make it 5 second long, frame rate 60, and click on create. Drag and drop the fusion composition on the timeline like this, and here we have 5 second long fusion clip. Just place the CDI on it and then go to the fusion page. And here we have the media out node. Just drag and drop the media out to the side for now. Let's start by creating a background. So this is the background node. Drag and drop the background on the flow window. If you want to take a preview of this background, simply drag and drop to the viewer. Here we have a black background. Let's change the color of this background. Simply go to inspector window and this is the color. Select the white color from here. Perfect. So this is the white background. Now let's create a polygon shape. So it's very simple. Just take another background. This is going to be the stroke. Hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, or simply right click on the background, click on rename. I'm going to call it stroke. Hit OK. Perfect. And then we have to attach a polygon node with this stroke. So this is the polygon, drag and drop, and you can connect the polygon with this stroke. Simple. And then we have to do some setting with the polygon. But before that, we have to merge the stroke with the background. It's very simple. If you want to merge this foreground with the background, simply connect the output of this foreground with the background and you will get a new merge. Simply drag and drop the merge to the viewer. Select the polygon and do some setting. Just go to inspector window. First of all, we have to remove this animation, which is pre-attached animation. So just right click on that, click on remove polygon 1 polyline. And then we have to uncheck the solid option and increase the border width. Simply you can set any value, something around 0.095, and here we have to create a polygon. Before start creating polygon, just right click on this preview window, go to guide and turn on this show guide. You can take a reference by using this guide. Perfect. And then we have to create this type of polygon shape. Now you can do some setting with this polygon. Simply select the polygon, go to inspector window and click on this option here. Perfect. And now you can arrange these shapes, create a shape like this. Now let's animate the polygon. Just go to frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second according to 60 frame per second, because we are working on a 60 frame per second timeline. So here we have the length. Just right click on length, click on animate, and then just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the length value 0, and here we will get something like this. Let's animate the position as well. So just go to 4 second right over here on the frame number 240, and the right click on position, click on animate, and then go to the end of this animation. Let's increase the position value, and finally we will get this type of animation in and the animation out. But this animation is linear, so we have to make it smoother. Just go to spline window, check the length and position both, click on fit button, highlight these two keyframes. Hit S to smooth, highlight these two, hit S to smooth. You can also click on the smooth button to make these keyframes smoother. And let's play the animation. Here we have something like this, as you can see. You can also adjust the position of the shape if you want. So here we have the center. You can drag it left, right, whatever you like. And you can also adjust the rotation if you want. And after that, let's create a text. So this is the text. Connect the output of this text node with this merge and you will get a new merge. Drag and drop the merge to the viewer. Type anything whatever you like. So select the text. You can select any font style that you like. So in this case, I'm using Gotham font style. Here we have the tracking. Let's down the tracking amount just a little bit. Maybe I'm going to type new design. Perfect. You can align it to the center like this. Here we have the tracking. Let's set the tracking amount 0.95, I guess, and it's looking perfect. Here you can increase the size of the text if you want, but this is looking nice. Here we can create animation on the text layer. So just go to the end of this animation, right click on size, click on animate, and you can set the value 0.08, which is the default value. And then just go to very first frame of this animation. Here we have to increase the size. Let's set the size 0.1. Perfect. Here we have zoom out animation on the text, as you can see. it's looking nice. You can also create a smooth graph for the scale animation. So just go to a spline window. This time, uncheck the polygon, check the text only, click on fit, highlight both the keyframes, click on a smooth button. And here you can connect the output of this merge with this media out, and it's almost done. Select the merge, hit Ctrl plus a space bar, and attach a motion blur. I am using DaVinci Resolve Studio, so that's why I have motion blur. If you are using free version, you can check the motion blur. If you have, then attach this motion blur. Otherwise, you can leave it. This is an optional step. Perfect. And then just go to the edit page, and here we have the first text animation, which is looking like this. And now let me show you how you can create multiple design using only one text like this. Simply, you can create a duplicate of this text, hold Alt on the keyboard and drag this fusion composition like this. So this is the second copy of this animation. Let me show you how you can create a different design. Simply, you can apply any video overlay on it. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and I'm going to use this film burn transition, and I will give you a link in the description so you can download this film burn. Simply drag and drop this video clip on the timeline and place the video clip over on this second clip. Perfect. So here we have this type of film burn transition. You can cut the extra part and delete the extra part by hitting backspace. Now let's blend this burn transition. Select this video clip, go to inspector window, and here we have the composite mode. Select this composite mode screen, and now this is the second design, which is looking nice and unique, as you can see. Perfect. Now let me show you the third one. Simply create a copy of this, go to fusion page, just select the stroke, go to inspector window and change the type solid color to four corner, and select four different color from here like this. Perfect. So it's looking nice, as you can see. This is the text node. You can type anything whatever you like, and then go to the edit page, and here we have the third one. And now let me show you the last one, which is very important. So just go to the first clip right over here, go to fusion page. Here we have to select these nodes, hit Ctrl C to copy, and then go to the edit page. Here we need a video clip, so just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and I'm gonna use a video clip. So in this case, I'm using this video clip. Of course, you can select any video clip that you like. Click on open, drag and drop the video clip on the timeline. Select 5 seconds of the video clip like this. Add a cut, delete the extra part by hitting backspace. Place the video clip right over here, and I'm gonna fit the video clip. So just go to inspector window, increase the zoom value, and fit the video clip like this. And then I'm gonna use an adjustment layer. So just go to effect, go to effects, and this is the adjustment clip. Drag and drop the adjustment clip on the timeline and place it on the video clip like this, and then go to the fusion page. Here we will get media in and out. Just deattach both the nodes, place the media out right over here, media in right over here, and then you can simply import that setting or hit Ctrl V. So this is the node from the first clip. Now let me do some setting. So this is the media node, drag and drop over here, and drag and drop to the viewer to get a preview. This is the background. Just deattach this background, which is the white background, as you can see. I'm gonna merge this background with this media in. So I'm gonna place the background right over here, take a new merge node. I'm gonna connect the background point with this background, foreground point with this media. Drag and drop the merge 3 to the viewer, select the merge, and here we have the blend option. Just down the blend value, and I'm gonna set the value 0.1, I guess, which is equal to 10%. And here we have to apply the black and white effect on it. So select the media in, add a color corrector node, drag and drop the color corrector to the viewer. Here we have to set the saturation value 0 and make it black and white. And then you can drag and drop this merge 3 to the viewer, and here we have the background, which is looking like this. And then I'm going to use this polygon and a stroke node, hold shift on the keyboard, drag and drop over here, and I'm going to attach one more color corrector node with this media in. So take another color corrector, place it over here. I'm going to connect this input point with this media in output. like this. Drag and drop the color corrector to the viewer. Here we have the output. Select the color corrector 2, and this is the saturation. Let's increase the saturation. Set the value 1.5 in the saturation. Hit enter. Now I'm going to place this video clip inside of this shape. So we have to take a new merge node. I'm going to connect this yellow background point with this stroke, because I'm going to use this stroke as a background, and green foreground point with this color corrector 2. And I'm going to place this foreground inside of the background shape. So drag and drop the merge 4 to the viewer, select the merge, go to inspector window, and this is the operator. Just select the operator over to in, and now we will get something like this. And after that we have two different output. First one is looking like this and the second one is looking like this. Now let's blend both the outputs together. So this is the merge node. I'm going to use this merge 3 as a background and merge 4 as a foreground. Drag and drop the merge 5 to the viewer. And now here we have something like this. And after that you can attach the text node. Simply deattach the text from here and place it over here. Connect the output of this text with this main output, and here drag and drop the merge 6 to the viewer, and you can delete these merge node and connect the motion blur with this merge 6. Find out this media out and connect the media out with the main output. Perfect. So this is the node construction you can see here. Perfect. And now you will get something like this. You can add one more animation on the text. Simply just go to frame number 30, which is equal to half a second, or maybe frame number 15, which is equal to quarter a second. Select the text, go to setting. Here we have the opacity. Just right click on opacity, click on animate. Go to very first frame of this animation, set the opacity 0. And do the same thing at the end of this animation. Just go to frame number 285, right click on opacity, click on set key, go to the end of this animation, set the opacity 0. Now we will get this opacity animation first, and then we have the text reveal animation. And of course you can experiment anything with this design. So this animation is almost ready. Just go to edit page, and here we have the fourth design, which is looking like this. And let me show you the great feature of this method. Simply you can import any other video clip such as this one. Drag and drop the new video clip on the timeline. You can select 5 seconds of the video clip, and now you can fit the video clip from here. And now if you want to apply same text animation on this one, simply you can copy this adjustment clip by holding alt and place this adjustment on the second video clip like this, and here we will get the same text animation on the new video clip. Simply you can place the CTI on it and go to fusion page. Here you can change the text. Perfect. And then go to the edit page, and here we have the first design, second design, and the third design, and finally this is the fourth design, which is looking awesome. And now let's have a look. Just go to very first frame of this animation, hit Control F to full screen, and let's have a look. All right, it is looking awesome, right? So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. For more such videos, subscribe to this channel, like this video, and also comment below what you think about it. My name is Vikas Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.